Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Studio West High School national premiere of Big Fish. We ask that you please turn off all cell phones and refrain from flash photography or videotaping, as they are a distraction to the actors. There will be a 15-minute intermission between acts, and if you need to leave, the show will be streaming live to the lobby. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy Studio West Big Fish.
My own way. said I met a witch when I was very young? What if I said she showed me how I died? Powerless in the face of it, terrified in the wood. That was where my life was changed for good. Hey, what if I said I met a giant wasting in a cave? What if I claimed I rose to be far braver than the brave? All my life and story, son, and everyone is true. So believe me as I'm telling you. How? Will.
Dad, why do you tell so many crazy stories?
Because it's who I am. Why does the sun shine?
Because of fusion.
Lord, Will, it was a rhetorical question.
Edward!
Put that book at me.
Why is the light still on?
Now you're in trouble.
Shut up, Will.
Edward Bloom, it is 9 o'clock on a school night. Let this boy sleep.
Oh, well, I was just about to finish this chapter on Agamemnon. Now, why can't anybody have a normal name like Chuck?
Mom, can you really make a fish out of a river by doing the Ave Mastom?
I suppose anything's possible. For example, I've heard legend of a brave and handsome man who happily fixed the leaky sink in the bathroom the very first time his wife asked, without excuses or delay.
Well, now that there's a myth. Except for the brave and handsome part.
Lights out, both of you.
You heard your mom.
Dad?
Son?
Did you really need a witch?
I did, but see, your mother tells me I can't tell you that story. You'll get nightmares.
I'm not scared.
Well, neither was I at first. Now, it's a well-established fact that every southern town of a certain size has a witch.
Do we have a witch?
No, but we got two Dairy Queens, so we're still coming out ahead. Now, small town witches mostly keep to the minor incantations, love spells and whatnot. But of all the witches in Alabama, there was the one who was the most renowned, for she could see the future.
And she told you the future?
She showed me. Well, that night in the swamp, three of us went looking for her. Just three teenage boys on a dare. I didn't know it, but she would change my life forever. We're walking in circles, Don.
Oh, do you want to leave, Bloom? Go ahead. I don't even think there is a witch.
You asked for it. Well, yes, the future's quite clear.
What do you see? Do I get quarterback?
You lead an unexpected life full of minor triumphs and major disappointments. And then you die.
What? That's it?
That's all the spirits you can use.
Well, I want to know how rich I'm going to be.
A dollar poorer than when you started. Now, as for you.
I want my money back.
Oh, don't. She'll hate you. Come on, give it back, Don.
How about I smash it? How you going to do fortunes without your crystal ball?
So give it back!
Or what, Blue? You think you can take me?
Here's your money, Tom. Now hand it over.
Witch lover.
Witch lover!
Don't you want your fortune?
Let me guess. I lead a disappointing life, and then I die.
Everyone dies, Ed Bloom. Your death is glorious. Let me show you.
Why would I want to see how I die?
What's your concern? Are you scared of hearing one thing new? When you could learn something secret that'll help you through. In one good turn, I can show you how to be wrong. Yours is no ordinary life. You've become important, Lord.
Dad, seriously, you need to get dressed. The wedding's in 45 minutes.
Oh, would you say that? I almost got seven.
Seven's good luck. You'll need luck over with that baby coming.
Well, what are you talking about?
Josephine's pregnant.
How do you know?
Because you just told me.
Just now, see, back when I was working at the circus, I developed a knack for reading expressions. Useful with lines. Plus, she didn't drink at the rehearsal dinner.
Okay, Dad, nobody knows that she's pregnant, okay? You can't tell Mom.
Why not?
Because it's super early. Statistically, there's a good chance it could not even happen, so...
Statistically?
Yes.
You, an Alabama boy, meaning an American girl all the way over in Baghdad. Now, what are the odds of that, statistically?
Well, we're both reporters, so it's not that remarkable.
Oh, Lord. Well, I would hate to see all the rainbows in your world. I bet they're all shades of gray.
It's just the baby. I don't want to jinx it.
Oh, relax, Will. That's seven. Everything's gonna be fine.
Okay, promise me you won't say anything. And about what we talked about earlier, no stories, no toasts.
Well, now when have I ever embarrassed you? All right. I'm not so good around orchestras, but I really thought I could play that violin. It doesn't look that hard.
Honey, get dressed.
Oh, Will was holding me up. Oh, but look at you. Oh, come on, give me a kiss.
Just in my face now. Go on clothes.
Oh, hey, is that a violin? Oh, hey, let me see that. Hey, come back here.
Are you nervous?
No. Yes. Mom, about Dad, I know that you can't control him.
I could just as easily control the weather.
Dad is like the weather. I can predict him, sort of, but I fundamentally don't understand him. He's this baffling hurricane.
Well, if you're gonna worry about anyone, worry about your poor mother abandoning me for a woman on television.
Oh, you love Josephine.
I do. We turn on the cable news sometimes just to watch her. She's pretty and kind and smart. Oh, but you're my little Alabama lamb all the way up there in New York. Want to practice one more time?
Absolutely. Back. Together. Side. Together.
Not out loud.
Oh, right.
Better. That's it.
Josephine and I are just unbelievably grateful to have so many friends here to help us celebrate.
For those of you who don't know, this is actually where Will proposed to me. 1 year ago at the banks of this river, I had just met Edward and Sandra. I knew I wanted to be a part of this family.
So before we get to dinner, we have a couple things to get to.
Yes, good evening, everyone. My name is Edward Bloom, and on behalf of me and my wife, Sandra, she's the gorgeous one right there. It is a pleasure to welcome y'all to Alabama. Now, Will told me I was not allowed to give a toast. Well, you'll notice there's no glass in my hand.
Technicality.
No technicality, he says. Now, Will thinks I talk too much, but I would have love at a talkative father. Well, my own daddy, he was a farmer. Lucky to get 4 words out of him. But one day, I heard him out in the field, just, you know, blathering at length. talking about how we couldn't get a word between me and my mother. But the corn? Well, the corn was all ears. Oh, wait, where's that waiter at? Waiter. Oh, thank you. Now, on the topic of fatherhood, I have an announcement. After careful consideration, I have decided to become a grandfather.
Dad!
Now, I'm sworn to secrecy, but I'm told that my ambition may be fulfilled sooner than I dare hope.
Okay, it's time to catch the bouquet. Ladies, follow me.
Oh, come on, Will, it's good news.
It's too early. 1,000 things could go wrong.
They won't. Why are you such a pessimist?
I'm a realist, Dad. And yes, it's good news, but it's our news. Why do you have to make everything about you?
I was excited. I got carried away.
You always get carried away. And I'm sick of it.
Well, I'm sick of you treating me like a child. What kind of a son doesn't let his father give a toast at his wedding?
The son whose father does this!
Grow up, Will.
I did! You weren't there. You were never there.
Calm down.
I was building a business.
You're running away.
From what? From you?
From reality, Dad. All I ever got from you was a bunch of crazy stories about how awesome you are, and I'm sorry, but that's not the man that I see.
Well, maybe you never bothered looking.
Stop it, both of you. Before you say something you can't take back.
I'm done.
So am I.
You all right?
That boy is bullheaded. I don't know where he gets it.
Asking about you. What's going on there?
Put your stethoscope away, Doc. I'm fine.
How long has this been going on?
I don't know, a while. It's nothing.
You lost weight.
Well, exercise. What, didn't you see me dancing out there? I'm fine.
I'm sure you are, but come in Monday so we can be doubly sure. I'm trying.
It's just off to the right.
Wait, my right or its right?
A little bit of patience will now hold it still. And there, the light!
A penis! It's a boy! We're having a son!
If it's bad news, just tell me.
It's not what we want to see.
The tumor didn't shrink?
No, it's spread than what we thought.
But that doesn't mean...
Of course it doesn't, honey. Just means I have ambitious cancer, is all. Right, Doc?
Exactly.
Well, keep going, though, right? Or try something new.
There's a conversation to have about what's next.
Now, Sam.
We need to call Will. I never should have kept this from him.
Will doesn't know about any of this.
He's got his own life up in New York. No sense bothering him.
I can't believe this is really happening.
Do you think I was making it up?
No.
I'll go get dressed.
Okay, I'll meet you outside.
Well, we're having a son.
I know. Son. Stranger! Different, like something old has joined with something new, but still feels true. I'm passing through a rite that every parent does. I'm walking on some shared familiar ground. Yet every step I take is not a step at once. My everything, my song the same. Father, and suddenly the weight of it is real. What do I feel? I feel connected in a way I've never known. A line from dad to me to newborn son. So from today I'll never make a choice alone. One for all, common sense. Listen and you'll learn and you'll excel. I'll tell my son that life is lived in clear and present tense, not only in the stories we can tell. My father told me stories I could never comprehend. In every tale he claimed to be the hero. I've tried to understand him, but I wonder if I can. Because after almost 30 years, I still don't know the man. I wish I knew the man, but he's a stranger. My father is a stranger I know very well. A puzzling shell. Mom, have you and Dad talked about money?
Oh, we have plenty of money.
Is the house paid off?
Years ago, the day we sent in the last check, we had champagne. Your father opened it with a sword. There was glass in the carpet for weeks.
Mom, you won't mind if I look for the mortgage, the insurance, and all that. I'm worried about you, about what's gonna happen. We have to keep a roof over your head.
I'm not worried about this house. I'm not worried about me either. I'm worried about you.
Oh, Mom, you don't need to worry about me. I'll be fine.
Oh, I'm fine. You sound just like your father. You are the two most stubborn men on earth, and it's my curse that I love you both.
But he's mine. There are two men.
worry?
People needn't worry so much. It's not my time yet. This isn't how I go.
Right, the witch.
The witch?
There was a woman in the swamp who told him how he died.
She showed me how my life ends, and it don't happen like this.
So how does it happen?
Oh, surprise ending. Wouldn't want to ruin it for you. No, but you? Well, forget the life you know, because having a kid changes everything. I mean, well, there's the diapers and the burping home and the midnight feeding.
Wait, did he do any of that?
No. But I hear it's terrible, just awful.
Well, I should probably go get dinner started.
Oh, I can help.
No, no, you two stay out here and talk.
Come sit with me.
Hey, I wasn't trying to pick a fight earlier.
Here, you can feel him kick.
Oh, he's strong. When is he coming?
22 weeks, so...
So 5 months.
5 months? Well, you'll tell him about me. Only the good stuff.
Of course.
Yeah, Dad, actually, I'd love to hear more about the real versions of events. Stories you. Maybe we can go over some things while I'm here.
You mean while I'm here?
So I want to know the full history. I know you grew up in Alabama, but was it right here in Montgomery?
Oh, not too far away. A tiny little place called Ashton. Our town was so small that our phone book was the yellow page. Oh, our town was so small that our zip code was a fraction. Our town was so small that we only had 3 jokes. But I tell you, the best thing about growing up in a small town like Ashton, a boy with ambition can be a pretty big deal. All right. I'm coming in! Just what I thought. The only giant you are is a giant coward.
I'll smash your bowl and eat you for dinner.
You'll still be hungry. I'm more of an appetizer size. Ever Blue.
Get out of my head.
No, I came here to talk to you.
Well, I don't want to talk. I just want to be alone.
Oh, bullcrap. You are alone, so you're only pretending it's what you want. Underneath all those dead animals and death threats, I see a guy who might need a friend.
You don't know me.
Oh, well, sure I do. See, up until now, I've been the biggest thing in action. But seeing you is a reminder that there's something bigger out there.
So go!
Well, come with me. Look, this town is too small for you, and it's too small for a man of my ambition. When was the last time you got out of this cave?
I'm agoraphobic.
I don't know what that means, but you gotta get outside.
You're not very bright.
Well, how smart are you?
Real knowledge is to know the extent of one's ignorance.
Whoa, that's deep. Wow.
There's nothing for me out there. I don't fit in. I've never even been in a car.
Well, you got those giant legs, so walk.
But I won't fit in a house.
We'll sleep under the sky.
But I'll never find a girl.
Oh, John, this is the South. We like our women big and beautiful.
But
you can pine your life away, wishing things were better. Waiting here for Judgment Day while knitting you a sweater. But I believe that kind of life won't set your spirit free. So my friend, one small suggestion. Country's flesh and blood. On a ride that's countryside and Mississippi mud. Hit the street with two big feet to bear your heavy load. Go live life out there on the road. Everywhere you wanna be with anything to say. Come tomorrow, you'll be free of who you are today. Action and adventure when we change our fixed abode. Respected like a king, where it's all civilized, you'll be surprised. The songs you hear me sing, when people all reach you there, some want to share enthusiastic news. And all you need is a guarantee with one big pair of shoes. One big pair of shoes. Hey, what's your name, Giants?
Carl.
Listen, Carl, the world is huge.
197 million square miles, approximately.
Say, you're good with numbers.
Only the big ones.
Naturally. Come on, let's get out of this cave. Don't you wanna step outside? Look around, see what's waiting there. We were born to wait, each morning, it's a place we've never been. Checking out the notebooks as they watch us checking in. Something.
key to the city from when he was a teenager. Your father left Ashton in search of adventure.
Oh God, he got to you. He seduced you.
Do you know how your mother and father met?
They met in college. Wait, which story did he tell you? There are like 7 versions of how I met my mother.
This was romantic.
They're all romantic. My father is romantic. Was the giant in it?
Yes, Carl!
So, Carl the giant. Supposedly my dad's best friend, but I've never met him. There's no photo, no actual evidence that he ever existed. I'm worried that my dad is going to be gone and I'll never know what was true.
Does it really matter what was true? Your father was telling these stories for a reason. If you understand the stories, you'll understand the man. How many stories were there?
I don't know, I've never counted.
You should make a list.
Okay, let's do it. So chronologically, it starts with the witch. She teaches him what, not to fear death? Okay, then he meets the mermaid.
And she teaches him about love, how love transforms a person.
Oh, I thought she taught him how to swim.
You never listen!
So my father and Carl leave Ashton and they go on a series of wacky misadventures that roughly approximate the 12 labors of Hercules.
What about the tornado?
Fine, the tornado. It's not important.
It's incredibly important! Your father was headed for the big city, but then fate pushes him towards love!
You've got a lot of hormones in your body right now. Okay, so the winds of destiny take them to Callaway Circus.
Hear it.
Ship, ship,
Suddenly you see her. Time stops. What you thought you knew changes. Life beyond this moment is better. Time stops, but still your heart is beating. Time stops, though you don't take a breath. She's there, and all you've ever wanted is nearer, clearer. I used to think the world was small. Now I don't think that way at all. Time stops when dreams come true before you. Time stops when fantasy is real. I knew this moment was expected. This good, good.
That boy is staring and I feel a chill. I don't know why that boy is staring. The world is still not tumbling by. There's no one talking, but I can hear.
It's not plausible.
It's romantic.
Dwayne is Callaway. What's your name, Pat? You got a name? No. Does it matter? More exotic if you don't.
It's Carl.
That works. Say, Carl, have you ever considered a career in the world of entertainment? More importantly, have you ever heard of the term?
Wait, what is
it? Unconscionable contract.
It's an agreement in which one party grossly misrepresents facts in order to take advantage of the other party's perceived ignorance.
Well, that's a thorough definition.
I want 30% off the top and all the food I can eat.
10%.
20. And I won't do nudity.
And no one's asking.
Done. Hey, Edward, what's wrong?
Carl, I just saw the woman I'm gonna marry. I know it. Then I lost her.
Oh, heartbreaking. Most men gotta get married before they lose their wives. Oh, but the good news, one of us deserves to be happy. Kid, this girl, real pretty, blue dress, red hair.
Who is she? Where does she live?
Oh, I know her, Daddy. She's out of your league.
What do you mean? You don't even know me.
And let me guess, you were the hero of Hickville, a big fish in a small pond. Well, this here's the ocean and you're drowning.
Take my advice and get back to Puddleville. You'll be happier there.
Look, I may not have much, but I've got more determination than anybody you're ever gonna meet. I'm gonna find that girl and I'm gonna marry her and I'm gonna spend the rest of my life with her.
Go write your harlequin romance somewhere else. I have got a circus to run.
If you tell me who she is, I'll work night and day. And you won't even have to pay me.
Okay. Once a month, if you work, if you slave, if you cry for me, then I'll give you a clue. Oh, once a month, if you clean, if you haul, if you die for me, then the clue will be true.
Let me give her those daffodils. Tell me who she is.
Hell, her name is Sandra Templeton. She goes to Auburn University.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Calloway. Thank you. Carl, how far is Auburn University?
763 miles.
Then I'm going to need your help.
Fellas, bring it out.
my father buy a house with another woman.
As the stars that shine
stretch in never-ending line, till all I saw was daffodils beside the lake. The daffodils are just an introduction to the blossoming of me and you. Beside the lake, beneath the tree, beyond mistake, marry me, please marry me.
But you hardly know me.
I have the rest of my life to find out. Edward.